Well, it's rather a long, and I choose the long reading because I don't want to cut any corner on the special day. What you saw today, I tried to make a point by dressing Kalina differently. What day do we celebrate today? Come on, there's no way about Palm Sunday. Very good. What are all the names we call Palm Sunday? The Passion Sunday. What are all the names we call the Palm and the Passion Sunday? Okay, I will give it to you. They used to call Palm Sunday, and probably you know the reason why, right? We bless the palm, we possess it. But then later on, they call the Passion Sunday, which means we read the Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ. And then the church said, well, no, but that's not that what we really celebrate, neither Palm nor Passion Sunday. So the church changed the name to the Palm Sunday of the Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ. It's a combination. And if you see, the liturgy are really divided into it. The first part today, when we bless the palm and coming in, I wear a white robe. And probably not the picture you saw when Jesus riding on the so not intelligent anymore. I talk about that. He didn't wear red, did he? No. You saw, you know, on the drawing, Jesus riding wearing a white robe. You can see the spirit of joyfully riding in, the victorious riding in, the welcoming of the great kings arriving. You can feel the spirit in the air. People screaming, yelling, not out of anger, but out of joy. And then as we process it in, I walk over, change into the red vestment. The opening prayer. You bring the book up for me to Tommy, not Tony. I read it out for you. And then I start the Mass with the opening prayer. Almighty and ever-living God, who is an example of humility for the human race to follow. Isn't that weird? Did we just walk in and say Hosanna the highest and change it to a tone of example of humility? Isn't that funny? Caused by our Savior to take flesh and submit to the cross. Graciously grant that we may heed his lesson of patient suffering. That doesn't make sense, isn't it? And then you lead into the readings that might read to us. And then the passion, the tones go down into the passion and the death of Jesus. We move from the glorious entrance into the deep down suffering of a human person. That's what we celebrate today. We just don't celebrate the Palm Sunday. We celebrate both glorious and passion. That's why the church changed the name, no longer Palm Sunday or Passion Sunday, but the Palm Sunday of the Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ. Now, with that long passions, I can preach for 3 days and 3 nights. And you know, when I start rolling, preaching on the Word of God, I don't stop. So I decided to put a little part of that to preach on. And let me tell you, before I go on to preaching, you know, I wasn't here last week. I went to a retreat. And you know what I miss the most? Everywhere I go, adult, I loved you, but I really don't miss you. I meet these kids, these young people, the smiling face and waving at me when I celebrate Mass. I do miss it. You know, that's because I go somewhere, you wave at the kids and they go like, Father, what did I do wrong? You know that sense? Over here, they ran over, they hugged me, they smile. I miss that everywhere I go. So kids, I love you and thank you for being part of my life. Probably you are the only reason why I'm still around here in this church. Not really, but you are the reason that whenever I go to retreat somewhere, I want to come back. Because I do miss you guys. Your smiling face, go to church and waving at me with a smile. It just made my day. I love it. But anyway, let me go into the homily. Today I'd like to choose to talk about the woman. Because as you see, the gospel scene opens with the woman and ends with a woman. The gospel scenes today open with the man complaining about what the woman do and ends up with the man running away and the woman stay. Did you pay attention to that? The woman arrived and the man complained that they didn't sell that and blah, 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 blah. And then the gospel ends with Jesus' death. And then all the men ran away and the only woman stayed. So today I want to talk about the woman. Particularly the unnamed woman today who came and bring her. I'm going to read that word out because I don't use perfume, so I can't even know what that is. An alabaster jar, what the heck that is, I don't know, probably a pretty big one, isn't that what it means? An alabaster jar of perfume oil, costly, genuine, fine, what is that? It's like the Chanel, is that what it is? I don't know, maybe it's more than the Chanel, because they said, if they sell that, it would cost more than 300 days' wages. It's like your whole year's salary, people. Am I right? This is your whole year's salary. And so what kind of perfume today can be equivalent to your whole year's salary? Anybody can feel me? Not even one today, right? So this is expensive stuff. Anyway, she came. She came. And she wanted on one Jesus. But I like the way how the gospel recorded it. How did she do it? Did she open the jar? What did she do?
Break
it. That's weird. You don't break that jar of 300 days wages and then pour over Jesus' head. The gospel recorded clearly. And remember, I told you this year we read it from the gospel of Mark. And who's Mark hearing it directly from? Who's that? Who is the disciple? Who he following?
Peter.
Remember that homily I gave you? So this is directly recorded from Peter. She broke the jar. And I want to dwell on that word. Because that means a lot during this holy week. That broken, that breaks, is what being logic into many things. Jesus was bruised and broken. He took the bread, he breaks the bread. And he gave thanks. Set the blessing. That's what you and I, we celebrate. So for us this week, this holy week, I'd like to invite you to focus on the word broken. Broken. Let bricks away from the sins that we used to dwell on. Let have those sins spread it out and hand it over to Jesus. And some of us probably is being broken right now, dealing with issues in our life. Some kind of addiction, dealing with our own internal illness, cancers, things that we don't want and don't know how to deal with. Dealing with a loved one who is suffering and the doctor doesn't know what happened. I want you to bring those moments of pain, bruised, broken to the altar of this week of the passion of our Lord Jesus Christ and hand it over to him. And tell him, Lord, let me break these suffering with you. Lord, I may not understand why I'm doing this. Why do I have to go through this? But I know there gotta be something in here for me. And I want to bring it with you And I want to place in front of you, and I want to be part of your passion, of your suffering. Now, how many of you have watched the movie The Passion by Mel Gibson? Raise your hand. Ooh, that's pretty a lot of people. Let me be the first one who raised my hand and tell you, I never watched it because I couldn't handle the suffering.
Oh my God.
I see pieces a little here and there, but I could never have my gut to sit down and watch that. And they said that the church is accredited from the church. They say it's pretty close. Now imagine if you saw that person walking the street and being beat up like that. And today, one of the words the gospel say, when they handed him over, they blew at him. They throw blows at him. I can't handle that. Now I know myself have been part of that suffering. But it's hard. I just can't watch it. But are those death the end? No. That's why we only have one week of the passion, actually not even one week, into the Easter. So this week, my dear beloved, let's spend some time with him. Let break our sins with him. It is easy for us, the whole crowd is saying, Hosanna the highest, blessed is he, screaming and joyfully. But when we break our sin, we need to do it privately because we don't want other people to see either. So I invite you this Holy Week to spend some time with him. Could be in your home, could be in your room, could be if it's too noisy in your car. And most important, in the church, during this Holy Triduum, Holy Thursday, when we have the Mass, the Last Supper on Thursday, and then after that adoration, all the way to midnight, let's try to spend some time in quiet with him. Let not our sleep taken over so that he has to turn around and say, can't you just stay awake for an hour? Let's spend some time in quiet with him in a tomb on Fridays. Let walk the station of the cross on Friday. And let rejoice with him on Easter Sunday. Use some time to be with him, to make that personal connection. We know that. We Americans are very good at that. When somebody in sorrow, we show up. The ministry of the church are surrounded with those moments. When Jesus is in sorrow, are we going to learn like the man today? We're going to all run off? Are we going to learn like the woman and stays? I make the choice, and I pray that you make the right choice to stay with God. Because by staying with him, not because it's good for him, you know what we do mean nothing to him, but give you and I the strength, the courage to continue this journey to enter into eternal heaven. And until that day, may everything we do give the glory to his name. Amen. Amen.